Allah is His name. And this is the name of God Almighty, even in the Bible. Which Bible? People keep on asking, which Bible? I said, look, there are dozens and dozens of versions. But in every version, the name Allah is there. Every version. Any version. There is a group of people, they call themselves Jehovah's Witnesses. They originate in America. They are the most militant group among the Christians. They are the fastest growing cult in the world today, Jehovah's Witnesses. That group of people, they are propagating throughout the world that the name of God Almighty is Jehovah. They go and ask other Christians, he says, what is the name of God? So you say, God. He said, God is not a name. God means an object of worship. You say, the God of the Hindus, gods of ancient Greece. God is a name term applied to any object of worship. Like the Frenchman says, money my God, woman my guide. It's not a name. God is not a name. It's a title, an object. What's his name? Is a father? You say, your father is God? He says, no. What's his name? Then he would say, his name is Jehovah. All right, for a moment we accept. But he says, you know, in the New Testament, in the original Greek, you say it was preserved in Greek. You said yes. The original revelation of God, he said yes. In the 27 books of the New Testament, the word Jehovah does not occur even once. Not once in 27 books, in the original. So what kind of a name is this? If God Almighty inspires his book, why is he ashamed to reveal his name? That means afraid, he's ashamed. Like saying, Saddam, my name is Saddam. Anyway, your child, maybe you have named him out of some love for the guy, but as the child is growing, is going to school, it'll be difficult because I'm Saddam. Or in Western, I'm Hitler. You don't say, I'm Hitler. Maybe you are an innocent man, you may be a priest, you may be a very kind, saintly person. But say, I'm Hitler. What's your name? Say, Hitler. What's my name? Say, Saddam. No, it's very, very difficult. You see? So now, is God ashamed of his own name? If that is his name, I say, in the 27 books, the word does not occur even once. And you say, God dictated it? He inspired it? He said, yes. Then how is it that his name is not there? In the 27 books, not there at all. So we say, look, amazing thing. The name Allah is still there. In your book, they have their own translation called New World Translation. They don't accept this Protestant Bible. They don't accept it. They have their own translation called New World Translation. I said, in your New World Translation, Allah is there. In the Zulu Bible is there. In the Arabic Bible is, has to be. In the 2,000 different languages in which the Christian world has translated the Bible, in the 2,000 different languages, the word Allah is there. It's not been, they have not been able to eliminate it. Amazing. So where is it? I said, look, you remember when Jesus Christ is supposed to have been on the cross, according to Matthew and Mark, Luke, in two places, he is made to say, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. So I'm asking, does Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani sound to you like Jehovah, Jehovah, lama sabachthani? He says, no, unless there's some sickness in your ear. I said, listen, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. Does that sound to you like Abba? Abba lama sabachthani? Abba means father in Hebrew. He says, no. Then I said, listen. Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani in Hebrew. Allah, Allah, lama taraktani in Arabic. Sound similar? Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. And say, Allah, Allah, lama taraktani. Sound similar? I said, yes. Then I said, in the book of Revelation, the last book of the New Testament, of the Bible, John the disciple, he sees a vision. And in the vision, he hears the angels in heaven singing, Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. I'm asking the Christians, have you heard that before? Yes. When the Christian goes into ecstasy, like we say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. What does the Christian say? Alleluia, Alleluia. I said, right. I want to know what is Alleluia. Is it hip hip hooray? Hip hip hooray. Is that what it means? No. What is Alleluia? I'm asking, what is Alleluia? Alleluia. You see, the Arabs and the Jews, we begin with an exclamation in our language. It's the genius of the language. Alleluia, we start with Ya. That's the genius of Arabic and Hebrew. I say, Ya Akhi, O my brother. Ya Ummi, O my mother. Ya Allah, O Allah. We start with Ya. You, the Westerner, ends with Ya, meaning exclamation mark. You say, Fa! Exclamation mark. Stop! You say, exclamation mark. Your thing ends, your exclamation is at the end. Our starts with the beginning. So, Alleluia is Ya Allalu, Ya Allalu, Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu. I said, that is what we are singing. We are singing, the Muslim is singing. Oh Allah, you are the only being who deserves worship and praise. Oh Allah, you are the only being who deserves worship. Ya Allahu, on the cross, Allah, 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 my Allah, my Allah, my Ilah, my Ilah. This is his name, as it is there to be found today. But people, the name gets stuck in the throat. The name gets stuck. They don't want to hear that word. So when I tell them, I says, you know, in my meetings, in my country, and other places in the Western world, when sometimes the Christian comes along and he asks a question, and all the other Christians shout, Alleluia! They have done it. You see, this, you have done it. Great. In other words, saying, Hippie hooray! Hippie hooray! So I start explaining. I said, you see, thank you very much for praising the name of the Lord. And what you're saying is that, oh Allah, you be praised. And I said, oh, thank you very much, because this is how the word comes about. Ya Alleluia is Ya Allalu, Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu. Thank you very much for reminding the people that praise the Lord, praise Allah. No more Alleluias. Believe me, no more Alleluias. You just explain to the guy, said, look, this is what you're doing. Thank you very much. Thank him for it. And no more Alleluias. Finish his silence.